James, you recording? Championship Saturday concludes here. A glorious evening at the Oakland Alameda County Coliseum is the site for the CIF North Coast Section Division I Baseball Final between the number 1-seeded De La Salle Spartans of Concord and the number 10-seeded California Grizzlies of San Ramon, live on your home for high school sports, CIFNorthCoast.tv, part of the Play On Sports Network. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is Stephen Davies with a welcome, and it's my pleasure to be joined once again by Todd Flournoy, James Davies behind the camera, and our producer, Alex Richmond. Once again, you are tuned to CIFNorthCoast.tv, your home for high school sports. The number 1-seeded Spartans are back for another crack at Division I crown, their first since the NCS reshuffled the division structure following the 2008 season. They lost in a heartbreaker 1-0 in the 2011 final to James Logan as two costly errors in the bottom of the sixth inning led to the lone Colts run. Graduate Logan West is brilliant for De La Salle, throwing a complete game one-hitter in the loss. In 2012, De La Salle defeated Heritage 13-6 in the second round of the 2012 playoffs as Mitchell Cranson went 4-for-5 to pace the Spartan offense, then defeated Granada 9-3 in the semifinal round, with Cranson going 2-for-4 and Stephen Herding 2-for-3 with two RBIs. Starting pitcher A.J. Puckett went 5 2/3, giving up 7 hits, striking out 2 and walking 2 as well. California have been called the Cinderella team in this 2012 Division I bracket, and with good reason. The Grizzlies finished joint third with Granada in the East Bay Athletic League, finishing behind Monte Vista, San Ramon Valley, and De La Salle, who beat the Grizzlies in both regular season encounters. But led by manager Dan Ward, the Grizzlies are white hot entering this title game, first defeating a tough Bishop O'Dowd team 10-7 as Kevin Farley went 2-for-4 with a double and two RBIs and pulling out another miracle win as they defeated Deer Valley of Antioch 8-7 thanks to A.J. Velasquez's 2-for-4 performance with four ribbies. Then in the semifinal round, they defeated arch-rivals Monte Vista 5-2 to book their place here at the Coliseum this evening, thanks to Farley's 3-for-4 effort with a home run and two RBIs and a strong 5 1/3 innings from Nate D'Amelio for the win. Todd Flournoy is here with me once again at the Oakland Alameda County Coliseum, or the O.co Coliseum, if you like. And Todd, maybe said that California may not be really all that willing, or I shouldn't say willing, but on paper you wouldn't think they'd make it quite this far in the playoffs, but they have had a sensational run, and they're up against De La Salle, a team they've lost to already twice this season here tonight.
Will is definitely not something that the Cal Grizzlies lack for. They have a tremendous amount of heart to even make it to this championship game after almost missing the playoffs, and they needed to win one of two in their final week. But they've gotten some guys healthy, they've had a lot of timely hits and good strong defense, and hey, any given Sunday, I know that's a football term, but it's almost truer in baseball. Any team can beat any other team on any given day, so we'll see if Cal can pull off the upset here and take the North Coast Section Division I championship over De La Salle.
Yeah, you say they had to win one of two because they lost to both Amador Valley and Foothill, losing to the Don 7-0 and then to the Falcons 7-6, so they had to beat arch rivals Monte Vista 3-2 to get into the playoffs and a chance at this title game. We will take a quick break as we go to the national anthem. Be right back with you for the start of the Division I final in just a moment. Back with you live on CIFNorthCoast.tv for this Division I championship game between the number 1-seeded De La Salle Spartans of Concord and the number 10-seeded California Grizzlies of San Ramon, live from the Oakland Alameda County Coliseum. Here's Todd Flournoy with the lineups for the two teams.
De La Salle Spartans are your visiting team. They're leading off with Hunter Mercado at right field, the junior. Batting second is Sean Peters, the center fielder. Batting third is the catcher, Mitchell Cranson. First baseman Alan Smoot will clean up. Austin Lone Star, the DH, is batting fifth. Steve Herting, the left fielder, will be batting sixth. Third baseman Chris Fornacci is batting in the seven hole. Shortstop Mike Berdar is hitting eighth. And batting ninth, the second baseman Kevin Hare. Looking at the Cal Grizzlies, your home team tonight, you got the sophomore Cameron Santos leading things off, playing shortstop. Just been on the team a couple of weeks. So batting second is Travis Roberts, the second baseman. Batting third is the big senior Thomas Peter, who's been battling a thumb injury all year. He's batting third and playing third base tonight. In the cleanup hole is Kevin Farley, the senior first baseman. Batting fifth is Daniel DeFazio, the junior, and he'll be DHing tonight. The catcher, A.J. Velasquez, is a sophomore. He'll be batting sixth. Left field and batting seventh is Tyler Johnson, the senior. Batting eighth is Blake Guardino, a junior, playing center field. And batting ninth is right fielder and sophomore Nick Allman. Back to you, Steve.
Thank you, sir. So we're all set to go then in the top of the first inning. De La Salle will bat. The battery for California, Cody Ball, the senior on the mound for the Grizzlies tonight. Behind the plate, A.J. Velasquez, the sophomore catcher. And he's quite the slugger here. He's in 26 games this year. He's batting 333, 22 for 66. Three doubles and a home run. So he's definitely providing some pop for California. But they'll have to deal with the De La Salle Spartan offense as Mercado, Peters, and Cranson will lead things off here for the Spartans. 59 degrees here at first pitch from the Oakland Alameda County Coliseum. And with Michael Smith here in the building, got to do the quick Spartan or the quick uniform check. Mine, of course, not as detailed, but I'll try my best. De La Salle in the black uniforms with the gray pants. Pinstripe pants, it appears, with the white and black uniforms, the Nike swoosh on the left shoulder. California in a much more reserved road gray uniform with the black hats and the orange trim. So all set to go then from Oakland Coliseum, the fourth game on our schedule today. And Hunter Mercado, the left-handed batter, will step to the plate here to face Cody Ball for the first time. Here's a delivery from Ball, a right-handed pitcher. That one's going to be high for ball one to Mercado. He'll be followed by Sean Peters, the center fielder. So Ball on the season so far, 5-2, 3.87 ERA. Second delivery from Ball is up high and outside. So two balls and no strikes. So 5-2 for Ball on the season, 3.87 ERA. Holding opposition batters to a 253 average, 67 innings pitched. Here's a delivery. That one's over the plate for the first strike of the evening there to Hunter Mercado. So 2-1 the count now here in the top of the first inning to the left-handed Mercado, junior outfielder. Another pitch there from Ball over the plate. Two balls and two strikes to count.
Ball really pulled the string on that one.
Yeah, he certainly did. Evens the count up at two balls and two strikes after falling behind 2-0. Delivery from Ball is shot to right fielder and making a diving play. Can't come up with it. It's the right fielder. That's going to roll to the wall. Mercado Hall or Hood around second base on his way to third. He's going to make it up sliding into third base to beat the tag. And that's the way you get things started for De La Salle as he smashes that one to right field out of the outstretched glove of Holman. Can't come up with it. And a triple for Mercado.
Yeah, and that's not what you want if you're the Cal Grizzlies coming in as an underdog. Cody Ball absolutely hung a 2-2 curveball, and Mercado did not miss it, jumped all over it. A nice diving attempt by the right fielder out there for Cal.
Nick Allman,
but maybe a little too risky at this point not to just take that one off of a hop, missing on the dive, going all the way to the wall, and an easy triple for Mercado. Great start for De La Salle.
His second triple of the season, and Allman was at full stretch there in right field, but couldn't come up with it as the ball carrying past him and off the wall. Here's a delivery now to Sean Peters, and that's well outside. Ball one.
You know, a common theme we've been seeing in all of these games, it's been a surprise to me, the infielders are almost always in when there's less than two outs and there's a runner on third base. So Cal taking a chance here and trying to eliminate that first run from crossing home plate.
Mercado on third base. Here's the delivery. That's going to be low for ball two. Look good from here. So Peters with a hitting count now, 2-0, and he'll step out for a moment. Sean Peters, the center fielder for De La Salle. He's a senior outfielder, 6'2", 170, batting 389 on the season in 26 games. And two ball, no strike count. Swings at that one, gets a piece, fouls it off to the screen, 2-1.
Yeah, nice cut there by Peters. Just missed that one.
Outfield straight away, a line to center field. Infield in, as Todd mentioned. And they're really taking some chances here in the early going, perhaps favoring opportunity to get an early out here.
Whoa, another hanging curveball there by Cody Ball. He better tighten that thing up a little bit, perhaps a little bit of nerves right here starting out. I am surprised that they are playing in right now. Cal is obviously trying to protect that first run. They feel that if they get down early, they won't be able to come back.
Not a lot of velocity on that curveball there for sure. There's another one that's going to be low in the dirt. And the California catcher, Velasquez, does a good job of preventing that from going past him. So a full count now to Peters. And already De La Salle with a runner on third base. That's Hunter Mercado. A sliding triple there as he belted one to right field to open the proceedings here. Delivery swung on a miss. Good pitch.
Go. Nice pitch right there to get the strikeout. Much needed.
Yeah, definitely. Indeed. Cody Ball coming back with a fastball there to strike out Sean Peters for the first out of this first inning for California. It'd been a beautiful afternoon here at the Oakland Coliseum, but now the clouds starting to make their way back in as we move into the evening hours here. Floodlights in full effect.
Senior Mitchell Cranston steps into the box, the left-handed hitting catcher.
So they go left, right, left here, the top three batters. Ball's delivery to Cranston in the dirt. And again, Velasquez scrambling to his right to prevent that from going past him to the backstop. So ball and no strikes here to Cranston. And this is really the danger man here for De La Salle. 25 games, he's batting .388, two home runs, 23 RBIs on the season so far. He's also a threat to steal with 8 stolen bases in 9 attempts. Pitch is going to be inside. It's 2-0 now to Cranston.
Ball could really use a strikeout right here, just like he got on the last batter. And Velasquez, so far, he's doing a really good job keeping the ball in front of him. That's 3 in the dirt already that he's pounced on.
Yeah. Good point. And especially having to range to either side as well. Here's a curveball again hanging in the zone. Cranston gets around on it, fouls it off right side. And that's a little troubling for the California starter there, that leaving the curveball up like that in the zone. Right around the letters there, and lucky that Cranston didn't smash that one down the line, similar to the way Mercado dealt with the curveball back at the start of the inning. Here's a delivery that's going to be chopped foul left side.
Yeah, you could see that Cranston was looking for the curveball on that one, being way out in front. I think they're all, with this dangerous De La Salle lineup, they're all looking for curveball right here because they can see that, at least early on, Ball's having a hard time locating that and getting the velocity he needs on that curveball.
2-2 count now for Cody Ball. Here's the delivery. Curveball again. He leaves it hanging and just foul. Boy, that was fair well down the right field line. And just at the last second as it approached the bullpen mound there, it hooked foul. The count remains 2-2.
Ball living dangerously with that curveball early on. You know, they actually let the sophomore catcher call his own pitches, one of the rare things you'll see this far into the North Coast Section playoffs. Most of the managers call the pitches, but this duo right here, they call their own pitches. Maybe they should go with old number one a little more often.
From the first base side of the rubber, ball sets. Here's the delivery, and that's swung on and hit to right field. Going back is Allman. He's going to make a long run to the warning track and reels it in. Mercado will score from third base, so a sacrifice fly there from Cranston. He gave that a ride to right field, just there short of the out-of-town scoreboard. So a sacrifice fly from Cranston scores. Mercado and De La Salle have their first run of the game home.
Yeah, I think that would have been out of pretty much every high school park in the area, Stephen, but that one did able to stay inside here at the Coliseum. But they do get on the board with the sac fly from Cranston. 1-0 De La Salle.
So that will clear the bases. And Alan Smoot, another left-hander, comes up now for De La Salle. And this also will give Ball some and Velasquez something to think about here, as De La Salle seems to have a number of players that can bat from either side of the plate. 3 lefties are the first 4 batters here today. That pitch is swung on, grounded foul down the right side. So the count will even at a ball and a strike here to Smoot. Austin Lone Star, the man with the best name in sports, to follow. So 2 outs now. Cranston the second out of the inning as he is going to sacrifice fly to the warning track in right field. Dimensions here of the Coliseum, 330 down the line, 362 or so to right and left center along that jagged edge, and then 400 straightaway center field. delivery to Smoot is outside, 2-1. Velasquez trying to frame that pitch on the outside corner of the plate, unable to do so. It's 2-1 now to Alan Smoot. He'll be followed again by Lone Star, the DH tonight. Ball's delivery is in the dirt, and again, Velasquez scrambling to his right, using the chest guard there to knock that one down. So count goes to 3-1 now.
Alan Smoot hitting 477 on the season. 3-1 pitch upcoming here. You want to be careful in giving him too much to hit.
Delivery from ball is fouled off to the left side. Yeah, Smoot is not only a dangerous hitter, but he's also got some speed as well. Able to leg out 7 doubles and a triple during the season as well. So, left-handed bat steps in. 3-2 now with the foul ball. So, a full count. The second one of the inning coming up for Cody Ball. Here's the delivery. It's grounded to first. Farley has it, and he will flip to Ball for the out. So, really, what could have been a lot more damage in the inning. Cody Ball does a good job of limiting the De La Salle offense there. One run on one hit. No errors for De La Salle in the top of the first inning. We go to the bottom of the first. It's 1-0 De La Salle.
You can watch highlights or a replay of today's game in our on-demand section. And you can also buy a DVD or Blu-ray of today's game right now on CIFNorthCoast.tv. Click on Buy DVD, and you can order today's game right now. Have a game that lasts a lifetime, brought to you by CIFNorthCoast.tv.
He's Todd Flournoy. I'm Stephen Davies. Alex Richmond is producing for CIFNorthCoast.tv. James Davies probably wishing he bought a sweater right about now. So California out for the first three at-bats, and let's turn it back over to Todd for the California lineup.
Yeah, we got Cameron Santos leading it off as shortstop, and then Travis Roberts batting second base, and Thomas Peter batting third base to see if they can get it started here for Cal. Let's do the De La Salle defense right now while we have a moment, while the De La Salle pitcher Andrew Buckley warms up. You got Steve Herding in left field, Sean Peters in center, Hunter Mercado is in right field. The third baseman is Chris Fornacci, shortstop Mike Berdar, second baseman Kevin Hare, first baseman is Alan Smoot. The catcher is Mitchell Cranson, and the pitcher for the De La Salle Spartans is Andrew Buckley.
Andrew Buckley, 4-2 on the season, a 1.67 ERA, 42 innings pitch, holding opposition batters, to a 184 average, and that could be kind of worrisome here for California. But they have a couple of sluggers of their own here. Kevin Farley is a monster, batting .306 on the season, 4 doubles, a triple, and 3 home runs, 18 RBIs. Also, Daniel DeFazio. Another player to watch. He's going to be batting fifth here. He will DH for California tonight. But it will be Cameron Santos, the recent call-up from JV, you were telling me, Todd.
Yeah, he actually got called up the final week of the regular season, and they plugged him right in at shortstop and leading off, and he's done a heck of a job providing this team with a spark.
And a spark is what he'll need to apply here. Santos, Roberts, and Peter, the batters here for California in the bottom of the first inning. First delivery from Buckley's outside. He follows that one up with a strike to even the count at 1-1.
Cameron's nickname is Baby D, and I understand his brother Jeremy is a heck of a baseball player too, his little brother.
Future California Grizzly star to be sure. Santos files that one off right side, so ball and two strikes now. Buckley working quickly here in this bottom of the first inning. He's thrown from the first base side of the slab. Right-handed pitcher peering for the sign. Here's Buckley's high leg kick and delivery, and boy, you got Santos swinging there. Great pitch on the outside corner to get Santos, and that'll bring up Travis Roberts.
Yeah, I don't think the sophomore Santos has seen heat like that than Andrew Buckley just got him. He blew him away with that fastball.
So Santos has gone swinging on 4 pitches, and that'll bring up Travis Roberts. He's also a right-handed bat. The third baseman, Thomas Peter, will follow. One of 3 captains here for the Grizzlies. That pitch low and inside.
Travis Roberts is hitting .261 on the season. They call him T-Rob. And he's playing second base. And he's got 13 RBI, or 8 RBIs and 13 runs scored hitting out of the 2-hole.
Here's Roberts. Swings at that delivery. Buckley is coming with the heat right now, to be sure. And Roberts did well to catch up with that pitch and follow it off right side. So should be a ball and a strike. And it is. Scoreboard says two balls, no strikes here. Ball and a strike here to Roberts. Pitches over the outside corner. Boy, he's really coming with the heat.
Yeah, tough call there. That was just, must have been just on the black on the outside edge of the plate. Roberts not happy.
So 1-2 now. Buckley, again from the first base side. That high leg kick, delivery, swung on. He got a piece of it to stay alive. And again, Buckley is really locating that outside portion of the plate well at the moment. And Roberts having a hard time keeping up with the fastball right now. So the count remains at 1-2. One out in the inning. And now Santos, who struck out to lead off here for California in the bottom of the first. Delivery is swung on and missed. Two strikeouts now already for Andrew Buckley.
That one looked very similar to the one that blew away Cameron Santos. So Andrew Buckley wasting no time in attacking these hitters and daring them to hit the fastball. And so far, so good. Two up, two Ks.
Shift on the infield here as they move three infielders to the left side. So De La Salle will have Fornashi, Burdar, and Hare all line up to the left side of second base. Here's a delivery to Peter, and that's over the outside corner for a strike. I don't think Buckley's thrown a pitch inside yet tonight, Todd.
Yeah, he's definitely staying away, away, away. He must have had something in the scouting report. De La Salle's always been a well-coached team and a well-coached program. Case in point, the shifty you're seeing right now against Thomas Peter with three infielders on the left side. Thomas Peter's a 471 hitter, and this is he's been battling a thumb injury, and this is his first game back as the defense shift a regular.
Yeah.
Now that it's an 0-2 count, I wonder why they switched back to regular alignment.
Here's the changeup, and he got him swinging there. 1-2-3. Down go California, and three punch-outs for Buckley to start this bottom of the inning for De La Salle. And, well, after one, it's De La Salle 1, California 0.
Looking for a great place to advertise your business while reaching the greater high school community? Then you want to advertise on CIFNorthCoast.tv. We have great rates for your business while giving you the opportunity to get your message out to a very important demographic. For more information, give us a call, 619-677-3246. Want to have your game broadcast live on the internet, just like this one, and be able to watch it again and again on demand while making money for your sports program? You want to give your students the opportunity to create their own broadcasts for your school's athletic events? Then contact us at info@kbcsports.com. We offer season packages for schools, a full curriculum for your students, and an opportunity to raise up to $10,000 for your sports program. Again, contact us at info@kbcsports.com or give us a call at 619-677-3246.
Thank you, sir. Second inning then coming up from the Oakland Alameda County Coliseum. It will be Lone Star Herding and Fornacci for De La Salle. And for Cody Ball, really was able to minimize what could have been a potentially strong inning for De La Salle in the top of the first, especially after Mercado led off proceedings with a triple to right field. First delivery there to Lone Star is inside for a ball.
Yeah, Steve, I couldn't agree with you more, really, after that leadoff triple and the way that they were squaring up the ball. Lucky that ball only allowed one run in that inning.
Yeah, well, as you said, too, Cranston would have hit a shot to right that would have gone out in 90% of the ballparks, unfortunately. So these players, the Coliseum seems like Tiger Stadium right about now. Two balls, no strikes. There's a pitch over the plate from Cody Ball to Austin Lone Star. He showed bunt there. So 2-1 now, the count. So working from the first base side of the rubber. Here's a delivery from Cody Ball. It swung on, fouled off right side. And he did do a good job of that in the first inning as well. Was able to get pitches that the De La Salle batters like to take swings at and was able to get him to foul them off, giving him a chance to remain in the count as he's done so here with a two-ball, two-strike count to Lone Star. Here's the delivery. Pitch is grounded to second base. Roberts has it. Flips to Folly for the first out. So Lone Star is out 4-3, and I'll bring up Steve Herding.
Nice looking play by Travis Roberts, the second baseman. Let's do the rest of the defense here for your California Grizzlies and Coach Dan Ward. Left fielder's Tyler Johnson. Center is Blake Gardino. Nick Allman's in right. Thomas Peter is in third base. Cameron Santos at short. Aforementioned Travis Roberts, the second. Kevin Farley at first. A.J. Velasquez, the sophomore behind the plate. And Cody Ball is your pitcher.
Ball one to Steve Herning. Bat 277 this season in 21 games. 13-47. Three doubles, no home runs. 9 RBIs, 6 Ks, and 2 walks. Here's a delivery from Ball, and he got him swinging there. Good pitch upstairs from Cody Ball. Ball on the strike.
So far, Ball's missing a lot of bouts with the fastball, and they're squaring up the curveball. He was able to get the curveball out on that last hit by Austin Lone Star. But that fastball is looking a lot better at this point than that that off-speed stuff he's throwing out there.
Yeah, it's still a clear difference in velocity between what Buckley's throwing or what we saw him throw in that bottom of the first inning. And that's a curveball again, high. And that's a pitch now at the moment. He's really struggling with it at the moment. No location and not a lot of velocity either.
And the other thing I'm noticing is you can pretty much tell he's throwing the curveball before he even releases it.
Because he's dropping that right shoulder.
Right, exactly. His arm angle is so much different, and that release point of the ball is so much different on the fastball.
Goes back to the fastball there to get a full count now. So already the third full count of the game for Cody Ball. Here's the delivery. That's over the plate. Punch him out. Second strikeout of the day as he gets Herding looking there.
I think Herding might have been looking for that curveball there.
Yeah.
Ball came back with back-to-back fastballs to get the K.
So he gets Herding looking. Now bring it Chris Fornacci, a right-handed bat. So they go left, right, left, left, right, right, right so far for De La Salle. Seventh batter of the day coming up for the Spartans. And here's a delivery from Cody Ball. Inside, misses with the fastball. Brodar is next, and he'll be followed by Kevin Hare here for De La Salle in the top of the second inning. Paul Pierce in for the sign. Windup and delivery fouled off left side. Count evens at a ball and a strike.
Fornacci in there, particularly for his defense, not having a strong year at the plate, hitting 206 on the season, but a guy that brings a lot to the table as far as all the other things that he does. He's a good heady ball player and a good defensive player at that.
Yeah, just 7-34 on the year, swinging there. So, good chance here for Ball to get out of this inning. One ball, two strike count. He's already got two outs with Lone Star grounding out 4-3 and him striking out Herding. So can he finish off Fornacci here and get the Grizzlies back out? Here's the delivery. 1-2. Off-speed pitch. Fouled off right side. Count remains 1-2.
Pretty good crowd here tonight to watch this Division I championship here at the Oakland Alameda County Coliseum.
Yeah, anytime these teams in the EBAL get together, a good crowd is always guaranteed. And the Grizzly fans have come out in force from San Ramon. 1-2 the count. Shadows enveloping the field here at the Oakland Coliseum. Delivery inside, didn't get the call. Good pitch there to Fornacci, but didn't get the call on the inside portion of the plate. So the count evens at 2-2. Ball now, 2-2 count. Fouled off the pitch. That's going to come back over the screen. So another pitch fouled off. But this is a battling at bat here by Fornacci, fouling off back-to-back pitches here. And the count 2-2. Here's the delivery. Off-speed pitch. Got him. They're going to have to throw down the first, and they get it in time. So three quick outs. And after 1.5, it's De La Salle 1, California 0.
You know, it might seem a bit premature to talk about the 2012-2013 school year. But hey, in a little over 2 months, we'll be back on CIF North Coast TV with football action from around the section. Starting in late August, we get back to our coverage, starting on the gridiron with multiple games weekly. So join us this fall as we kick off the football season right here on CIF North Coast TV, your home for North Coast Section CIF sports.
It will prove to be a fascinating season in the North Coast Section, in particular with the realignments of various leagues within the North Coast Section. We still haven't got all the details on how that will shake down, but it's going to make for some interesting viewing, to say the least. So be sure to join us on CIFNorthCoast.tv as myself, Todd Flournoy, and the rest of the Play On Sports crew will present the North Coast Section football season. Should be highly entertaining. We're going to be covering Foothill in the East Bay Athletic League, Valley Christian in the what we assume will be the new Bayshore Athletic League, as well as some other teams still to be announced. So be sure to check out our football coverage. We already can't wait. We already won't be able to sleep just thinking about it. So you can imagine how excited we're going to be. Back to this game, though, in the meantime. And California now, with the 4, 5, and 6 batters up here, Todd, might have a chance to try and even things up here against De La Salle.
Yeah, let's just try to get the ball in play. They were not able to do it in the first inning with, you know, the first three hitters going down on strikes. I think Andrew Buckley's really got his mojo working here. We'll see if the heat, the heart, of the California Grizzlies lineup can get to him here in the second down, one zip.
Just 12 pitches thrown in the first inning by Andrew Buckley. And here he comes with the first delivery to Kevin Farley. And this is a guy for California that they need to get on base and they need to be doing some damage because he is really the focal point of this offense. Batting 306, 22 hits and 72 at-bats, 4 doubles, a triple, and 3 home runs, 18 RBIs on the year. That pitch is over the outside portion of the plate to even the count of the ball and the strike.
Yeah, Farley, the senior first baseman, is also the quarterback on the football team.
He is. A couple of the guys here on this California team played with the Grizzlies on the gridiron as well this season. That pitch is fouled off to the right side.
It's not bad. Oh, I play first base and I bat leadoff, or I bat cleanup and I play quarterback in the team. Not bad. Pretty good resume.
Ball and 2 strikes now to Farley. Here's a delivery from Buckley. That's outside. It's 2-2 the count. Daniel DeFazio, the DH, will follow. And then the catcher, A.J. Velasquez. The 3 batters for California here in the bottom of the second innings. De La Salle 1, California 0. Delivery is fouled off right side. So Farley remains alive in the count, 2-2. So Buckley already 17 pitches, 4 for balls, 13 for strikes. A 2-2 count here against the star senior first baseman for California. It's 1-0 De La Salle lead. Outfield slightly shifted to right, infield slightly shifted to the right side as well. And that ball is outside from Buckley. So full count now for Kevin Farley. You wonder if he's just going to see what Buckley will throw him here. See if he can draw the walk. Pitch is high for ball 4. So a walk to Farley. California have their first base runner.
Yeah, nice at-bat there by Farley. He knew he had to get on base by any means necessary and try to get something started here for the Cal Grizzlies. Worked a count. I think he was down 1-2 at one point and fouled off a couple and was able to draw the walk to get things started.
16th walk of the season for Farley. And he's been just a monster in the playoffs so far for California, going 3-for-4 against Monte Vista as DeFazio stands in, right-handed bat, and that pitch is high. So I was just about to say, I think it would be a good idea now for Cranston to go out and have a word, as Buckley's command here has deserted him slightly. Definitely a loss on the fastball, but command here just a little bit off after that impressive first inning. So his catcher Mitchell Cranston went out for a quick word, telling young Buck to slow it down a little bit there, and he'll throw from the first base side of the rubber. Ball and no strikes. Here's a delivery, and that's over the plate for strike. 1-1. Velasquez to follow.
DeFazio, the junior designated hitter, looking to get the first hit for Cal.
Delivery from Buckley is an off-speed pitch at times inside. Actually almost hit DeFazio there. Ducks out of the way.
DeFazio looked like he squared to bunt on that play. I'm not sure if it was a bluff or what. But the third baseman started charging, and he pulled it back and almost took it off the head.
Farley will take a generous lead off first base here.
Squares to bunt again.
Yeah, he does, and he fouled that off right side. 2-2 the count.
So I'm not sure what they're thinking here with your number 5 hitter, your junior designated hitter up there bunting in a one-run game. But obviously the coach is trying to get that man into scoring position by any means necessary, apparently.
Farley, not really a threat to run either. Just 1 stolen base on the year. That Ooh. Pitch is out over the plate for strike 3. DeFazio goes down looking.
Yeah, tough break for DeFazio. He thought he'd get that outside corner call. The umpire had called a couple of those on the black balls previously, but I guess that was too close to let go. Big strikeout there for Andrew Buckley to get the first out of the inning.
Yeah, the high heat over the outside corner of the plate right around the letters got DeFazio looking. So 4 Ks already for Andrew Buckley on the day. Kevin Farley, the runner on first base. California still looking for their first hit of the game. Here's a delivery from Buckley to A.J. Velasquez. the sophomore catcher, 5'11", 180 here, 26 games, batting 333. Impressive season at the plate for the sophomore, wearing number 17.
Pretty good numbers for a sophomore. This is my guy here, Velasquez.
And a strike over the plate, so the count evens here at a ball and a strike to Velasquez. Tyler Johnson, the left fielder, to follow. You're in the bottom of the second inning. One ball, one strike, one out. One runner on base. That's Kevin Farley on first. Another generous lead. Buckley. Great pitch over the plate there to Velasquez. One and two. And Buckley seems completely unconcerned with the fact that Farley's on first, perhaps knowing he's not really a threat to steal here. He hasn't looked over once. You look across the first out the corner of his eye as he sets for the delivery. On the first base side, here it comes. And that's fouled off right side, about eight rows back in the seats there along the first base side, right in front of the bullpen. Andrew, bunch of kids running after it.
Everybody wants a souvenir.
They do indeed.
Andrew Buckley working very quickly out there, the first time in a long time. He stepped off the rubber to recompose himself.
Throwing more from the center of the slab here as opposed to the first base side. Comes a 1-2 pitch. Off goes Farley, and he's uncontested down to second base.
We might have a balk here.
I think we do.
Yeah, it looked like Buckley kind of flinched a little bit before he went into his delivery. And, Farley actually had a really good jump on that. Not sure if it would have mattered, but the second base umpire called the balk and awarded Farley second base.
Yeah, he did have a good jump, though. And now he's on second.
Jeez, he didn't even look at him again.
No. That's grounded to third. Nice play over there by the third baseman, Fornacci, to fire across for the second out of the inning. But you're right, Todd. I mean, he didn't even glance back at Farley there as he took a pretty hefty lead off second place. But a nice play with the glove there by Fornacci to fire across to get Velasquez 5-3. And I'll bring up Johnson.
Yeah, that was a slick play by Fornacci. Went to his left, stabbed it, kind of took a few steps towards Farley, make sure he went back to second base, and fired it over to first to get the out. Nice play.
It's two outs now on the left-handed batting. Tyler Johnson steps to the dish. The infield, playing back towards the grass. The second baseman, Hare, has got 1 foot on the edge of the outfield grass. And you're right. I mean, you mentioned that in the first inning, Todd. De La Salle seemed to have a plan in on the infield for every single batter that California sent to the plate. Outfield shifted towards left. The infield shifted towards right. One ball, no strikes. Pitch is over the inside portion of the plate. Good pitch again there. It's Tyler Johnson from Buckley. Farley's the runner on second base.
Nice off-speed pitch there by Buckley. We'd love to get a hit here for Tyler Johnson. Big two-out hit with the runner in scoring position. We'll see what happens.
Johnson managed just 178 on the year in 22 games. He would like a hit indeed. That pitch is inside. It's 2-1 the count now. Third baseman Fornacci about 5 steps in or so along the line of third base. Bedard and Head deep on the dirt, more towards the outfield grass. Here's a delivery. That swung on, hit back up the middle of the field. Oh, nice play, diving there to stop it. And round third comes Farley. He's going to be... Oh, they boldly let him go. Farley should have been out by a mile of home plate. Instead, Buckley bobbled the throw there and couldn't get it to Cranston in time. So Farley gifted a run there for Cal as Johnson gets down with a single.
Yeah, like I said, he needed that big two-out hit, and they got exactly that from Tyler Johnson. A really nice play by De La Salle shortstop Mark Bedard going up the middle to keep the ball in the infield.
Right.
And I couldn't believe Farley tried to just round it third like he had hit it into the outfield. He didn't even hesitate, Steve. And he should have been out at the plate, but the pitcher bobbled the relay, and Cal was able to get the run across and tie it at one.
Yeah, Johnson smacked that between second and short, and as Todd said, it was a nice play by Bedard, but there's no way he was going to be able to throw out Johnson. And instead, Buckley bobbled the throw back to the pitching mound, and that's going to be skied to right. That's going to catch.
It's over his head.
It is indeed. Round second comes Johnson. He's on his way to third. He might go home here. The ball's to the wall. He is going for home. Johnson trucking to home plate. He's in there, and with a stand-up triple is Brake Guardino. So before we even had a chance, really, to mention Guardino was at the dish. He sends one over the the head of the right fielder, Mercado, who admittedly was playing in there, and he gets caught out big time as Guardino strokes a triple to right field, and he's standing in at third base.
Yeah, you're going to see somebody yelling at the junior Mercado to back up. He was playing real shallow and right, and even though his first step was backwards, he had no chance to get to that rocket from the eight hitter Guardino with a stand-up triple going all the way to the 367 sign out there and right. Cal takes the lead 2-1 here in the second.
So here's Nick Allman standing in, the right-hander, and he skies the first pitch to center field. That's going to hang up with two outs. And he will reel that in. So Allman will be disappointed with that one as he gives it a right out to center field. But California respond in a big way. Farley walked to start off the inning. And then on a Johnson single, hit up the middle of the field, Farley from second base, after a balk, is able to come all the way home. And then Johnson on a single gets home as well after a Guardino triple. So 2-1 Cal after two. Todd, what do you have for us?
KBCSports.com and the Play On Sports Network showcase great high school games every week. And now you can access our content using multiple platforms. Follow us on Facebook, get the latest KBC and Play On news on Twitter, or catch our highlights in high definition on YouTube. All of our content can now link to your favorite social media site. Share all the high school action you see every week, brought to you by your home for high school sports, KBCSports.com and Play On Sports. I tell you, Steve, that was an incredible inning by California to answer the run that De La Salle scratched in the first. After going down 1-2-3 in the first inning, they get the walk from Farley. They get two straight. I got a strikeout and a ground out. And then Tyler Johnson with the big hit following the balk that got Farley into scoring position. And an amazing turn of events turns a what could have been first and third with two outs into an RBI single, and then the next pitch, a triple from the eighth hitter. So Johnson and Guardino, the 7-8 in the lineup, not guys you expect to power the ball like that, came up big time in that second inning to take the lead for California.
And for innings 3, 4, and 5, let's turn it over to Todd Flournoy for the play-by-play.
While I'm talking, I might as well keep going.
Yeah, right?
Leading it off here for the Spartans is the shortstop, Berdar, who made a really nice defensive play in the second inning that should have prevented the tying run for California. He steps in there, hitting 365 on the season. The eighth hitter in the lineup after him will be Kevin Hare, the second baseman, followed by right fielder, junior Hunter Mercado. There's a ball outside and a bit high. It's 2-1 to Mike Berdar.
Back-to-back balls you've thrown by Cody Ball after Berdar fouled off the first pitch of the inning.
And how do you think Cody Ball's looking right now? You think he's got a little bit of confidence after that, you know, that big run that the Cal got in the last inning?
You'd hope so, but I think the thing he has to really concentrate on now is just working the different pitches in here and between him and Velasquez figuring out the best time to throw him.
Nice fastball right there. Gets the count to full, 3-2 to Mike Berdar. Berdar swings and pops one up behind home plate. Gets out of play. Souvenir for some happy parent.
I'm not sure he can rely on the fastball for the duration of this game or for his appearance in this game tonight. At some point, he's going to have to find a location with either a curve or some sort of change-up pitch.
Here's the 3-2 delivery. Swung on and skied into that big, huge territory of foul in the right over first baseman. Unbelievable enough room for number 11. Mr. Kevin Farley to make the play for out number one. Can you believe he got to that ball, Steve?
Well, I mean, as we've discussed many times already today, the amount of foul ground here at the Coliseum, but a great move by Farley. He's a left-handed glove, so he ranged out to his left. He was aware of where the wall was as he was coming up on it there and really made a nice play there in foul territory to reel that one in.
There's a strike to Kevin Hare. Really nice awareness by Farley to know he had all that room in order to make that play. He must have run 50 yards over there to get that ball over by the Geico sign. 1-1 is the count to your second baseman, Kevin Hare. One out and here in the top of the third inning with De La Salle losing 1-2 to California Grizzlies. 1-1 pitch is in the dirt. Another nice stop for Velasquez. 2-1 to Kevin Hare.
Hare batting 341, 25 games, 14 hits in 41 at-bats.
There's a strike on the outside corner from Cody Ball to even the count at 2-2. Here comes the 2-2 pitch. Swung on and missed. Kevin Hare goes down swinging. And that's the fourth strikeout already for Cody Ball in just 2 2/3 innings. Two out, nobody on with the top of the lineup. Starting over for De La Salle, Hunter Mercado.
Yeah, and he tripled to start off this game. It was an impressive start for De La Salle. But so far, apart from the...
I think that's the only hit they've had.
Yeah, they are. Just one run on one hit. And it was thanks to Hunter Mercado here.
Ball into his set. Here's the delivery. That curve ball they could see coming was low and inside, 1-0. Mercado Hood is the junior right fielder. Takes a strike on the inside part of the plate. 1-1's the count.
Like how he stuck with the off-speed pitch there inside. Found the inside corner there.
Nice curveball there. He's starting to locate that curveball a little bit better, Steve. Got that one on the inside corner to move the count to 1-2 with two outs.
He's finding a bit more luck with the breaking ball to the inside now. Of these hitters, rather than trying to go outside as he did in the first inning.
Here's the 1-2 delivery.
Got it.
Off-speed pitch. Got him looking. Another strong inning for Mr. Cody Ball as he sets down the De La Salle Spartans in order at the end of 2.5 innings here at the Oakland Alameda County Coliseum. It's the California Grizzlies 2, the De La Salle Spartans 1.
KBCSports.com and the Play On Sports Network showcase great high school games every week, and you can now access our content using multiple platforms. Follow us on Facebook, get the latest KBC and Play On news on Twitter, or catch our highlights in high definition on YouTube. All of our content can now link to your favorite social media site. Share all the high school action you see every week, brought to you by your home for high school sports, KBCSports.com. Don't forget to stay tuned for our CIFNorthCoast.tv post-game show, where we will select our player of the game as well as wrap up all the action from this ball game. That's coming up following the game on CIFNorthCoast.tv. And in that second inning, Todd, Andrew Buckley looked a little human there after that impressive performance in the first.
Yeah, he certainly did. And you get the feeling that California is the later in the game that this goes and they're still in it, and if they can keep this lead, the more confidence they're going to have. And you could say that when they took that lead, they're hooting and hollering, and they also have probably four times as many fans, so that
right.
can only help if they can keep this lead for as long as possible, put the pressure back on De La Salle and put the pressure on Mr. Buckley, who looks great but had a little bit of problem with his defense in the second inning to give Cal the lead. So we'll have the bottom of the order for California, the 9-man Nick Allman, the right fielder, sophomore, will be leading things off, followed by Cameron Santos and Travis Roberts. Nick, the right fielding sophomore, is hitting, I think that's .377 on the season. Do I have that right?
For Allman. Yeah, that's what I got, too.
.377 with 19 RBIs and 10 runs scored on the season.
Oh, this is Santos for California.
Oh, excuse me.
And Santos is batting .300, just 5 games, though, the call-up from JV.
Pardon me. Excuse me. Yes, it's Cameron Santos leading things off. It is the top of the lineup for the California Grizzlies. Roberts is up second and followed by Thomas Peter. Missed a batter there. Pardon me.
It's been a long day here at the Coliseum. Forgive him.
Oh, thank you for that. I appreciate that. It's a 1-1 count right now to Santos. In the bottom of the third here for the Grizzle. Shows bunt, but pulls it back, and the ball is low for a 2-1 count.
It's been an interesting at bat here for Buckley. Did have a little trouble locating the fastball in particular in that second inning. Down 2 balls and a strike here to Santos, but there he finds the gas. And now 2-2 count. He did blow away Santos on 4 pitches in that first inning.
Yeah, you have to think Santos is thinking about that a little bit. Here comes the 2-2. Fastball popped up, kind of in the same spot as the play last inning. Does he have enough room?
Oh,
no. Sort of hesitated there was the first baseman, Alan Smoot. Thought he was running out of room. He actually had more room than he thought and couldn't come up with the pop-up, giving Cameron another shot here with 2 strikes.
I guess Smoot didn't feel like doing a Derek Jeter impression there and diving headlong into the front row seats there.
Yeah, that would have been a heck of a play if he would have come up with that one.
Yeah, it's a tough point because it's where the seats protrude out into foul ground, and there's 2 separate places where the seats come out, and the ball was hit really right between the 2, so tough play all the way around.
Yeah, it would have been a really nice play. but Smoot unable to come up with it. Santos takes a ball high. Count is 3-2 to the sophomore shortstop. Buckley into his delivery. Here's the 3-2. Swung on and missed. Got him with the fastball. Santos goes down swinging for the second straight at-bat.
5 Ks now for both pitches in this game. And Santos punches out for the second time.
That'll bring up Roberts, second baseman, the junior, the boy they call T-Rob, number 12. Also struck out his first time up in the first inning. Here's the pitch. Fastball high. Roberts takes ball one. The lights are on here at the Oakland Coliseum. The sun is going down. Here's the 1-0 pitch. A shot to right center field. Drops in for a single. Roberts takes the wide turn around first, but decides to head back. Nice hit there by Travis Roberts. One on and one out for the Cal Grizzlies.
And I think we're seeing why California made such a run here in these 2012 playoffs, because the timely hitting in particular has been outstanding so far. We've seen Johnson, Guardino, and now Roberts, each with strong base hits to the outfield. And in the case of Mr. Guardino in particular, a stand-up triple as he smashed that one over the head of Mercado in the second inning to right field.
Yeah, you got no fear in the eyes of these Grizzlies at this point.
Again, why not? You're the 10th seed coming in. I mean, pretty much no one expects you to win except for the team themselves. And perhaps sensing now that Buckley here may need a little bit of a word of reassurance or two. Coach David Jeans has come out for a quick word.
Yeah, Coach Dan Ward of the Grizzlies told me before the game that they're really playing with house money right here. You know, nobody expected them to be here. He had confidence in this team, but they had some struggles early on and got into the playoffs. But the way they're playing right now, they're playing loose, they're having a great time, and they're enjoying the game of baseball.
Yeah, I mean, they're in the bottom of the third inning. They can keep pulling the run in each inning. I mean, it puts all the pressure on De La Salle.
Thomas Peter, the senior third baseman, steps into the box here, takes a strike, 0-1, 2-1 Cal. One out here in the bottom of the third. Runner on first base is Travis Roberts. Off to a big lead. There's a quick throw over.
Yeah, I think that'll shorten up Travis Roberts' lead next time out.
Yeah, Buckley had a nice move over to first. Roberts able to dive back in safely. Here's the 0-1 delivery. Outside corner, fastball, strike two. So Thomas Peter is quickly down in the count, 0-2.
Still plenty of hitting room there in right center in particular. Big gap between center and right, and then a lot of space along the right field line to where Mercado's standing.
Definitely shading Peter to left field is the De La Salle outfield. Here's the 0-2 pitch. Fastball, got him swinging. Nice heater, and he's really putting guys away with that heater. That's strikeout number 6 Andrew Buckley.
And again, it's that outside fastball.
Yep.
And the Cal hitters are really having a tough time catching up with it. But his location, especially in the outside corner, has been superb tonight.
Up next is Kevin Farley, the cleanup hitter, the senior first baseman who walked his first time up in the second inning. Digs in against Buckley. Fastball starts him off with the strike. Another nice pitch from Buckley, 0-1. Kevin Farley, the QB in the fall, trying to do his thing on the diamond. Two outs here in the second. Quick throw to first. Ooh, just gets back. That's Travis Roberts. Nice move by Andrew Buckley, keeping Roberts honest.
Still not afraid of showing up his lead.
No, he's not.
So actually, if anything, he's taking a bigger lead this time. And he's better be quick. Ooh. I was going to say, he's really going to have to be careful over there on first base.
You called it. They're having a nice little game of cat and mouse there between Travis Roberts and Andrew Buckley. Oh, he's taking another step.
There he goes.
He holds up. Snap throw to first by the catcher. Just makes it back. So Travis Roberts having a little fun out there on the base pass, making De La Salle think about him. Trying to get him to think into a mistake. He's off to another big lead here with two outs. I wouldn't be surprised if you see him run here with Farley up.
Roberts has 8 stolen bases on the year.
Here's the 1-1 pitch. High and away. 2-1 to Kevin Farley.
Yeah, this is an interesting game of cat and mouse, as you said. Roberts each time takes like a half step further on his lead.
Here's the 2-1 pitch to Farley. That's a looper out into right field, right at the right fielder, Hunter Mercado, who takes it. And that'll be the end of the inning for the California Grizzlies. One hit, no runs, one man left on base. And after three full, California Grizzlies clinging to a 2-1 lead over the De La Salle Spartans.
You can watch highlights or replay of today's game in our on-demand section. You can also buy a DVD or Blu-ray of today's game right on CIFNorthCoast.tv. Click on Buy DVD, and you can order today's game right now. Have a game that lasts a lifetime, brought to you by CIFNorthCoast.tv. And if you're looking for a great place to advertise your business while reaching the greater high school community, then you want to advertise on CIFNorthCoast.tv. We have great rates for your business while giving you the opportunity to get your message out to a very important demographic. For more information, please give us a call via telephone at area code 619-677-3246. 619-677-3246.
Yeah, it's a great way to raise money for your high school sports program is to align with kvcsports.com. You can get all your games done. You sell the advertising for the games with local businesses. It's really a great model. And something that, if you're an athletic director listening in on this, is something to think about doing. You raise money for your school, you get memories that last a lifetime, and you get to have these high-quality broadcasts that, well, high-quality maybe pushing it. I don't know, Steven, what do you think? High-quality?
I think so.
Yeah, I think we're doing a pretty good job here, but I wouldn't use the word high-quality. No, I'm just kidding. Anyway, we head here to the top of the fourth inning with De La Salle trailing 2-1. Looking to get things started is looks like Sean Peters is leading things off for De La Salle. Mitchell Cranson in two, batting second, and then Alan Smoot. First pitch is taken for a ball for Peters.
And we've talked a lot about Buckley tonight, but Cody Ball has quietly been very successful over these last two innings. Four out of six batters he's faced, he struck out, including getting Mercado looking in the third.
1-0 pitch is another strike. Or, excuse me, first strike. It's 1-1 here to Sean Peters. Center fielder looks at a curve ball from Cody Ball. Doesn't get the call this time. 2-1. Sean, the center fielder, struck out his first time up against Ball. Here's the 2-1 pitch. Squares to bunt. Pops it up behind home plate and up against the netting. Peters trying to sneak on base with the bunt there.
Yeah, almost like the drag bunt.
Yeah, hit the infield back. Probably a pretty good idea, but wasn't able to put it into play. So it's 2-2. Ball sets. Curveball is low. Moves the count to 3-2.
I think you got to go with a fastball here. Trying to challenge a hitter with a full count.
Here's the pitch. Fouled off. Sean Peters stays alive.
Six full count of the game so far here for Cody Ball.
De La Salle making him work a little bit.
Yeah, already 62 pitches here in the fourth inning.
3-2 pitch is in the dirt. Ball four, so Sean Peters does a good job of getting himself on base to start the top of the fourth inning here for the De La Salle Spartans.
First walk of the day for Cody Ball, but he had a feeling on the previous pitch when Peters fouled off the fastball, he's going to have to come back with some type of off-speed pitch that time, and in the dirt and well outside for ball four.
Dangerous position right here for Cody Ball, potentially, with 3-4-5 hitters coming up, starting with Mitchell Cranson, the senior catcher, sacrifice fly and an RBI in the first inning. Takes a look at a fastball inside and low for ball one. 1-0 the count to Mr. Cranson.
Bang, 388 on the year, 31 hits in 80 at-bats, 25 games this season, 2 home runs, 23 RBIs.
Nice numbers for Mitchell. Here's the 1-0. Same pitch as the last one, low and away. And that'll draw a visit from your young catcher. Wants to come out and have a word with Cody Ball.
Because we saw what kind of damage Cranson could potentially do in that first inning where he gave the pitch a ride to the warning track there in right center field, right around the scoreboard there.
Yeah, you definitely want to be careful here with Cranson. He's in a good spot. 2-0. Got a runner on base. Nobody out. Probably be looking for a fastball here.
Big gap in right between first and second here. Cranston's able to drive it.
Ball into his delivery. And that's another ball low and a bit outside. 3-0 to Cranston. With nobody out here in the top of the fourth, you think Mitchell will be getting the green light here on 3-0, Steve?
No doubt.
Here's ball into a set.
Velasquez set up outside. And
missed badly on that one.
Yeah,
drawing
he did.
A walk. So a four-pitch walk to Cranston. Now you might really be in trouble if you're Cody Ball and the Cal Grizzlies as cleanup hitter Alan Smoot, he of the .477 batting average, walks to the plate, and that'll bring in a large number of Grizzlies at first at the pitcher's mound to have a bit of a meeting, joined by their head coach and manager Dan Ward.
Adam Kimmel is warming up in the bullpen here for California. It looked a little rushed down there as Kimmel went out quickly to the mound, or out to the bullpen, I should say. And they may not stick with Cody Ball here much longer, especially if he gets another batter on or another batter on base here. He's already walked back-to-back batters now in the form of Peters and Cranston.
Ball did a nice job first time through the lineup, only giving up the one hit, but he's in a bit of trouble here, walking the first two men of the inning. And you got your cleanup hitter, Alan Smoot. Big Alan steps in, the lefty.
Infield playing in here, and it hit. Did it hit him? I think it may have. No, he turned away.
He just got away from it. Alan turned a bunt on that one. A bit surprising from your cleanup hitter, but in a game like this, wanting to move your guys into scoring position, he did pull it back. Let's see if Alan turns to bunt again. He's turned to bunt right now as Balt gets into his set. And he lays it down. Nice bunt to the third baseman who scoops it up. Throws to first for the out, but moves both runners into scoring position. A successful sacrifice for Alan Smoot, second and third with only one out.
Nice play there by Peter. Did well to field the bunt there along the third base line. And a confident throw down the first to get that first out.
That was a really nice looking bunt from Alan Smoot, somebody that you don't expect to be one of the better bunters. Very competent with the bunt. So here we go. Two runners in scoring position for Steve's favorite player. For De La Salle, Austin Lone Star, the DH. The wide receiver on the football team looking for the big hit to put De La Salle back on top here with two runners in scoring position and only one out. Cody Ball on the hill.
Lone Star grounding out 4-3, the first out of the second inning. And a chance here to put De La Salle at least back on level terms, if not in the lead, with runners in second and third.
Infield in as Lone Star looks at a fastball for strike one on the outside edge.
Infielded, playing in again here.
Yeah, everybody's playing in, yeah. The third baseman a few yards in front of the edge of the grass. Perhaps thinking about a squeeze. Here's a pop fly out to right field and fading into foul territory. So two quick strikes here for Cody Ball. Good job of getting ahead to Austin Lone Star here with runners in scoring position and less than two outs.
So you can throw him the fastball inside here.
Infield still in. Here's the 0-2 pitch. Inside. Oh, Mr. Cody Ball wanted that one, but the umpire was not going to give it to him. It was a bit inside, so 1-2 to Austin Lone Star.
See if he comes back with a fastball here. Really the only pitch you think could challenge the hitters at this point in the game.
Yeah, might be looking to go low and away with a curveball. Bounce one. Yep. Oh, hung a curveball a little bit. What was that, high? It looked a little bit high.
Yeah.
So it's 2-2 here to Lone Star.
Get a little dirt on the baseball here as he gets ready to deliver this 2-2 pitch. Again with the infield in.
Cody Ball out of the stretch. Here comes the 2-2. Austin swings. And hits a base hit to left field with the infield drawn in. Around to score is Peters. Cranston holds at third and a big hit from Austin Lone Star to get this game tied up at 2.
Went through the glove there of Cameron Santos. He was ranging to his right. He was trying to backhand it there. Ball hit smartly along the ground by Lone Star. Would have been a tough play for Santos there playing in at short. But good piece of hitting all the same by Lone Star. And De La Salle tied it up here in the top of the fourth inning.
Yeah, that's the danger of playing in like that. Mm-hmm. You don't have a lot of time to react to a well-hit ball.
Santos' positioning was correct. He just couldn't get the glove down in time. And that, you think that extra half a second he would have had if he'd been playing a little further back could have really helped California there.
Yeah, Santos is sort of kicking himself right now. He thinks he could have had that ball at a shortstop, a ball he normally would have made, slick fielding shortstop, but unable to make it. It would have been a really tough play.
Runners on the corners now. Corner infielders will play
still
in.
Still one out. There's a bunt. Run will score as ball turns and throws it to first for the second out, but De La Salle takes back the lead 3-2.
Another nice sacrifice bunt there, this time by Steve Herding to follow up the sacrifice bunt that was the first out of this inning from Alan Smoot, so that another runner scores as Cranston comes home. And De La Salle have the lead now 3-2 here in the top of the fourth.
Looked like a little safety squeeze, the Mitchell Cranston making sure that Herding put the bunt down, and he was able to put it in a nice position and score easily. So now we have runners on second base and two outs, and the batter is Chris Fornacci, the third baseman.
Kimmel coming back to the dugout now from the bullpen, so he could be ready to go here. And that one is...
There's a swing and a drive deep to left field, but well out of play. Not quite making the second deck. Nice looking swing there for Fornacci, who struck out in the second inning. Two runs already across for De La Salle on only one hit so far. A couple of walks, a couple sacrifices. Here's the 0-1 pitch from ball. Low and away to even the count at 1-1.
A little extra time there for Fornacci before he comes into the box.
Ball sets. The 1-1 pitch. Here it comes. Curveball. Well outside. 2-1.
Just a pitch he's just struggled with the location for more or less the entire game so far. And now trailing by a run.
Here comes the 2-0. Really swung on. Ground to third base. Able to stay down on it. Throwing way across the diamond. But did he pull his foot? He did. He did. He pulled his foot, and everybody's safe.
Nice play by Peter at third.
Yeah, he stayed down on the ball and rifled it, but just a little bit to Kevin Farley's right, able to pull his left foot off the base and keep this inning alive for the Spartans. So here we are, two on and two out. Wonderful charge, Peter, with an error on that one. Think you'll have to. Yeah, E5 is the call. Mike Berdar steps in against Cody Ball here with two outs, looking for another big hit for the Spartans. Takes the ball high, 1-0.
Now for Ball, just got to get out of this inning. Two runners on here. Any further runs scored by De La Salle could really be trouble for California. And he answers back well with a strike to Berdar, as Fornacci is uncontested down second base.
Yeah, balls and the catcher, Velasquez, are focused on the hitter here. And, gosh, look at the lead that Fornacci has at second base right now. Second and third and two outs. Here's the 1-1 pitch to Berdar. Swings and grounds it to the shortstop. Going to be a tough play, but he got him. Nice play there by Cameron Santos to get the third out. But De La Salle, the damage has been done for the Spartans. They retake the lead on a couple of walks, a couple of sacrifices, and one hit. Two runs total to bring the score at the end of 3.5 innings. De La Salle is defeating Cal Grizzlies 3-2.
It might seem like it's a bit premature to talk about the 2012-2013 year, especially, I guess, if you're a senior. Well, I guess it wouldn't really matter to them so much. But in a little over 2 months, we'll be back on CIFNorthCoast.tv with football action from around the North Coast section. Starting in late August, we get back to our coverage, starting on the gridiron with multiple games weekly. Join us this fall as we kick off the football season right here on CIFNorthCoast.tv, your home for North Coast section sports. And KBCSports.com, and the Play On Sports Network showcase great high school games every week. And you can now access our content using multiple platforms. Follow us on Facebook, get the latest KVC and Play On news on Twitter. We'll catch our highlights in high definition on YouTube. All of our content can now link to your favorite social media site. Share all the high school action you see every week. Brought to you by your home for high school sports, KVCSports.com, and the Play On Sports Network.
Good game so far here at the Oakland Alameda County Coliseum, as I call it.
Absolutely. And now it's going to be interesting to see how California respond. Once again, trailing in this game, and with DeFazio, Velasquez, and Johnson coming up now for the Grizzlies.
DeFazio, the DH, junior number 25, struck out in the second inning. Andrew Buckley going back to work for De La Salle against the 5, 6, and 7 hitter here in the fourth inning. Be nice for Cal to at least get a little more pressure on him, get some base runners here, get Buckley into the higher numbers here with his pitch count. It's still only 52 pitches through 3. There's a strike to Daniel DeFazio, the junior.
Certainly hasn't lost any velocity on the fastball so far.
That's a good point. It looks really good. Here's the 0-1. High fastball. DeFazio didn't really have a chance to catch up to that one. 0-2.
No, he didn't.
And Buckley locates that fastball on the outside edge. He's pretty much unhittable for these Cal Grizzlies. I believe the count is 0-2.
It is. Now 1-2. And again, we're going for that outside fastball. And when it's working as well as it is, why not keep hammering it home? A little bit outside that time.
Here's the 1-2 pitch to DeFazio. Swings, and there's a tapper down the right first baseline. Angles more towards the pitcher, who's able to collect it and pitch it over to first base for the out. And a really weird bounce on that little cue shot from DeFazio down the first baseline. Nice job by Buckley to stay on top of it and flip it over to first base for the out.
Yeah, I think DeFazio couldn't tell there if he really wanted to swing at that pitch. Decided too late to bring the bat back, and the ball had some wicked spin on it there as it initially rolled towards the right field foul line and instead carried back towards the second base side, and Buckley was right there to toss that over to Smoot for the out.
In steps A.J. Velasquez, the sophomore catcher. Takes a strike. Here's the 0-1 delivery. Outside corner, but no, doesn't get the call. That evens the count at 1-1. AJ grounded out to third base, his only at-bat of the evening. 1-1 pitch is swung on and missed. Strike two. Buckley peppering that fastball in there.
Both DeFazio now and Velasquez been facing two strike counts.
One-two pitch. Ooh. Nice location on that high heat. Buckley makes quick work of A.J. Velasquez. Two away for the California Grizzlies here in the fourth.
Yeah, 7 Ks now for Buckley on the day so far. 3 2/3 innings of work.
Tyler Johnson steps in. He of the RBI single in the second inning to give the Grizzlies the lead. Takes a hack at a fastball and pops it up near us. Can't make the play. Us.
Yeah.
A little out of our reach, but souvenir for some lucky fan. 0-1 is the count to Tyler Johnson.
Definitely the closest it's come to us today.
Yeah. I think I could read Rawlings off of that ball as it was coming up to us. We have two outs here in the fourth inning. Tyler Johnson, the big lefty, takes a swing and another hit up the middle, but this time a little bit towards the shortstop side. Up with it, throws it over to first, and that's a quick inning of work for Andrew Buckley. 1-2-3 go down the California Grizzlies in the fourth, and at the end of four complete innings, the De La Salle Spartans 3, the California Grizzlies 2.
If you want to have your game broadcast live on the internet and be able to watch it again and again on demand while making money for your sports program, if you want to give your students the opportunity to create their own broadcast for your school's athletic events, just like this one here from the Oakland Alameda County Coliseum, then please contact us at info@kbcsports.com. We offer season packages for schools, a full curriculum for your students, and an opportunity to raise up to $10,000 for your sports program. Again, it's info at kbcsports.com, or you can contact us via telephone at area code 619-677-3246. And we'll say it again, why not, because we all love football here. It may seem like it's a bit premature to talk about the 2012-2013 school year, but in a little over 2 months from now, we'll be back on CIFNorthCoast.tv with football action from around the North Coast section. Starting in late August, we get back to our coverage, starting on the gridiron with multiple games weekly. Join us this fall as we kick off the football season right here on CIFNorthCoast.tv, your home for high school sports. Changing pitcher now as Adam Kimmel has come on for California here to replace Cody Ball. So, Ball went four innings, three runs and two hits.
Yeah, nice little outing by Cody Ball. I wasn't able to keep the lead, but really to no point, no fault of his own. He had a hard time locating that curveball early on, but battled and certainly gave Cal four strong innings. And he'll turn things over to Mr. Kimmel, see if he can keep California in this game as we head to the top of the fifth inning. Leading off is Kevin Hare, the second baseman for De La Salle.
Ball had thrown 81 pitches there through four innings, so his time might have been close anyhow, and Kimmel seemed to be warm after that long fourth inning there for De La Salle as Ball faced seven batters in the inning. So Adam Kimmel here should be ready to go. 3-2 on the year, 3.46 ERA in 28.1 innings pitched.
Kimmel sets and fires. Fastball right down the pipe for a strike. Nice start there for Kimmel. Kevin Hare, a strikeout victim in his only time up in the third. Kimmel throws a fastball a little bit low and inside, even the count at one. Big, tall lefty into his windup. Here's the pitch. Looks like an off-speed pitch low in the dirt. Another nice stop by Velasquez. But a 2-1 count to the ninth hitter, Kevin Hare. Here's the 2-1. Low. 3-1. So the new pitcher, Adam Kimmel, in danger of walking the ninth hitter, Kevin Hare.
And he's got the top of the De La Salle order to worry about then. And
he does
walk him.
He does walk him on five pitches. Adam Kimmel throws a free pass to Kevin Hare, the nine hitter for De La Salle. Good job by Kevin to get on base to lead off the De La Salle fifth. And that'll bring up, like you mentioned, the top of the order with Hunter Mercado, who's already tripled in this ball game and scored the first run of the game.
Big lefty here having a little trouble with the location of the first batter there, Kevin Hare. And so he's going to have to get that sorted out in a hurry. De La Salle, a runner on and no outs.
Very little room for error here for Kimmel, who starts off Mercado with a fastball that was about foot and a half outside. So Kimmel having a little bit of struggle here, as you mentioned, finding the plate. And with this De La Salle power lineup coming up with the top of the lineup with Mercado, Peters, Cranston, and Smoot, you better get it figured out here in a hurry.
And Eric, too, warming up now for California in the bullpen. They got a couple guys actually down there on the bench, so it'll be interesting to see if Nate D'Amelio will potentially stand up in the bullpen there as well. That's a good pitch there. Come back.
Yeah, found the outside corner. Did Kimmel. Evening the count on Hunter Mercado at 1-1. Hunter's a nice-looking player leading off for De La Salle here. The slick lefty swings and grounds one foul off the right side. 1-2 is the count for Adam Kimmel. Just brought into the game after Corey Ball went four innings. Gave up two hits, three runs. Did Ball come out of the game completely, Steve, or is he somewhere out there on the defense?
No, he's done for the day, at least pitching it anyhow.
Here's the 1-2 pitch is high, 2-2 to Mercado.
Daniel DeFazio, the DH tonight for California.
Kimmel keeping an eye on the runner as he delivers, and there's a ball poked pretty hard out to left field. The shortstop a long way to go. Is he going to get there? Yes, he is. Oh, did he catch it? Yes. Yes, yeah, the umpire says he lost in the transfer, and they're going to get a pickoff and a double play.
Nice.
Unbelievable. It looked like Kevin Hare, the runner on first base, thought that the shortstop didn't have control of it. He took off for second base. The umpire said that he did make the catch and that he lost it on the transfer from the glove hand to the throwing hand. And Hare was caught in no man's land, tried to scamper back to first once he saw that the umpire had called him out. But a nice heads-up play by the shortstop, Santos, to turn and fire a strike to first baseman Kevin Farley for the double play. Nice play by California.
Yeah, great range shown there by Cameron Santos, making up for the error in the previous inning where he let the ball go through him. But they're ranging out to shallow left.
Here's a ground ball up to the middle to the second baseman. He stabs it and throws a one-hander. Does he get him? He does.
Nice.
What a play. A barehanded play by the second baseman, Travis Roberts, who throws it very quickly to Kevin Farley, who was able to pick it out of the dirt for the third out. Maybe that will be the momentum swing that California needs to get this game back on their side. Right now, after 4.5 innings, it is the De La Salle Spartans 3 and the California Grizzlies 2.
Yeah, middle infield is coming up large there in that bottom of the fourth inning, top of the fifth, excuse me, yeah, and you can see now the Grizzlies all out of the dugout huddling around here as they get ready to take the field here in the bottom of the fifth inning, but really some lifelines thrown to California there. Well, could have been real trouble after walking the leadoff batter, Kevin Hare. Some fine play from the middle infield as there bails California out of the jam, and now they're back out on offense here, trailing by a run.
Yeah, you kind of get the feeling that this is California's biggest opportunity now. They got some great defensive plays from their shortstop and their second baseman. They have the bottom of the lineup coming up. If one of these guys or both these guys can get on and get it to the top of the lineup, turn that lineup around in their third time through, you get the feeling that California has De La Salle sort of right where they want them. They've kept it nice and close. It's 3-2. They have last licks in this game as the home team.
Right.
I don't know. I think California likes where they're at, and they're certainly playing some inspired baseball here today at the Oakland Coliseum.
And more importantly, perhaps, they've got the guy that really caught De La Salle off guard here, the number 8 hitter, Blake Guardino. Don't forget, stroked triple to right over the
head
of Hunter Mercado, and you can be assured that he won't be playing so shallow out in right field this time around.
That's right.
Todd calling for the lights to be switched on here.
Well, Alex, they get lights on the field. I think we should have some lights here on the press box.
That's true. This is the first time really today that's actually been a necessity. It's 8:18 Pacific time here, and the clouds have rolled their way back in. So a gloomy evening now, but certainly bright lights out on the field.
Blake Guardino steps in for the Grizzlies. Nice first pitch fastball where Andrew Buckley, who's working his fifth inning here for the De La Salle Spartans. It's 0-1 count to Blake.
2-1 ratio on strike to ball count here for Buckley, with 63 pitches, 42 strikes, 21 balls.
Pretty efficient evening so far as he bounces the 0-1 delivery, and it's 1-1 now to Blake Guardino, the junior center fielder. Here's the fastball, a little ground ball in between. A long way to go for the first baseman. He flips it to the pitcher, covering Buckley, and they get him by a step. Nice play by the first baseman, ranging to his right, scooping it up and throwing it to to Buckley, the pitcher, covering first base.
Yeah, backhand play there by Smoot, ranging, as you said, to his right side. Nice play, and no panic there from De La Salle. That could have easily been a troublesome play there with Smoot having to range a long way in the whole right side, but did well and won out.
And Nick Allman steps in, the ninth hitter, the right fielder, struck out his only time up so far against Andrew Buckley in the second inning. Trying to get things started is the sophomore, left-handed hitter, takes a ball inside. One out here in the bottom of the fifth inning. Nick Allman is the batter. Here's the 2-0. There's a shot down left field and falls for a single right in front of the left fielder, who gets it quickly into the shortstop. Nice piece of hitting there from the ninth hitter, Nick Allman, with getting a base hit with only one out.
I had him flying out to center in the second inning, which would indicate that he did give the ball a ride at least, and that time a smart piece of hitting to the opposite field. And Allman is on base, and now the top of the order, and Santos definitely after making that fine play in the last inning defensively, will look to make up for the two strikeouts he's already got in the first and third innings.
Didn't mean to give you a strikeout, Mr. Allman, when you flew out to center field your first time up. Nice piece of hitting there in the fifth, though.
Sure.
And now we have the tying run at first base with Cameron Santos, as aforementioned, coming up to plate. The sophomore shortstop who's had a sort of an up-and-down game defensively, trying to get his first hit of the evening, takes the ball outside.
Allman with seven steals on the year, so Buckley will be aware of his lead off first base. And it may not be out of the realm of possibility for California here to try and swipe second base if they get a good lead. There goes Allman.
Yep.
Just as I said, he's going to get down there too. He's going to have to hustle, and he's in there. Throw is offline there from the catcher, Cranston.
Great call by my partner here, predicting the steal and a heck of a jump by Nick Allman, who is definitely providing the spark that the Grizzlies might need with a one-out hit and now a stolen base to get himself into scoring position with the top of the lineup coming up for California. Here's the 2-0 pitch to Santos, and it's on the corner for a strike, 2-1. Allman takes a pretty generous lead off of second base. Buckley paying him no mind. Takes a quick look over. Here's a 2-1 pitch. Swung on and missed at a high fastball. Santos certainly was behind that pitch. And with 2-2 here, we'll see if he shortens up and tries to protect from that third strikeout.
Yeah.
Allman off to another big lead off second. Buckley into his set. And here's the 2-2. No, he fakes towards the plate. Sort of does a pirouette off the mound. Make sure that Allman's not going anywhere. Santos ready to go. Here's the 2-2 from Buckley. There's a swing and a drive to center field. Is it going to hang up there for the center fielder? Yes, it is. Sean Peters hauls it in for the second out of the inning. For a minute there, I thought that might be over his head, but Sean had a good beat on it and makes the second out.
Encouraging, though, for Santos to give that one a ride out to center field after striking out the first two, because you can imagine if he struck out a third time, there would be a pinch hitter for the sophomore if he got a fourth appearance at the plate. And
that might be it for Andrew Buckley.
Coach Jean's out to the mound, but I didn't see anyone in the De La Salle bullpen for at least an inning.
Maybe just won't know. He's moving out. Looks like he's moving in the shortstop here. Mike Berdar might be coming in to pitch.
Was he just calling the infield in for a...
Or does he just want to talk to him?
Yeah, that's what it seems like. With Buckley only thrown 73 pitches, I find it kind of hard to believe they pull him now, especially with no one in the bullpen. But
it's a good point.
I think this is just to discuss the strategy here.
Yeah, certainly a big at-bat upcoming for Travis Roberts, who had a single his last time up, 1-for-2 on the evening, with two outs and the tying run on second base. Yeah, you're right. They are going to stick with Buckley. Just an alignment discussion at the mound.
And Roberts had that strong single back in the third. And, I mean, you figure with Allman's speed here, if Roberts can put this in play, then we got a tie game on our hands.
Roberts, the good-looking right-handed hitter, steps in. And here's the pitch. A little bit high. There's a throw back to second. Allman slides back safely. Mitchell Cranston trying to take a shot, perhaps picking off a snooze in Allman, but he was aware and was able to scamper back safely. 1-0 is the count to Travis Roberts. Here comes the 1-0. Nope, called for time. Granted by the home plate umpire.
Ricky Henderson-esque time call there by Travis Roberts, stepping out right at the absolute last second before the delivering.
We are at the former home of Ricky. I see him probably in the crowd somewhere. Here's the 1-0 pitch. There's a shot out to left center. Long way to go by Fernacci, but he's under it, and he makes the catch. So after five complete, De La Salle still clinging to that 3-2 lead.
Okay.
I'm going to send it back over to my partner, who's going to finish off the game for you guys. Steven, take it away.
Thank you, sir. So, California, still not going away in this game by any stretch of the imaginations. We've reached the top of the sixth inning here, but it's the danger part of the lineup coming up now. The 3, 4, and 5 hitters for De La Salle. It's going to be Cranston, Smoot, and Lone Star for the Spartans here in the top of the sixth inning. It's 3-2 De La Salle. De La Salle, 3 runs and 2 hits, no errors. California, 2 runs on 4 hits and 1 error. And the pitcher, Adam Kimmel, the junior, out for his second inning of work. Cody Ball went 4 innings, 81 pitches thrown, faced 17 batters, 5 strikeouts, 1 walk, 2 hits, and 3 runs. Not sure how many of those were earned, unfortunately. And for Andrew Buckley, still in the game for De La Salle after 5 innings. And the consultation there with manager David Jeans appeared to work well as he was able to get that final out, getting Roberts to fly out to left field. He also got Santos to fly out to center. So Cranston, Smoot, and Lone Star with 2 innings remaining now for De La Salle. Of course, looking for their first Division I crown, but have won the old Division 3A championship 5 times, or 6 times, I should say, in the past, in 2007, 2005, 2000, 1997, 1996, and all the way back in 1985. And De La Salle, of course, trying to erase the taste of the 1-0 defeat last year to James Logan, as De La Salle didn't even make the playoffs in 2010. James Logan winning that game 1-0, despite Logan Shaw's complete game one-hitter for the Spartans. They sure would love to add a Division I crown here to their total so far. In the meantime, this pitch is swung on. First pitch is roped down the right field line. That goes foul, and that carried a long way. A nice piece of hitting there by Cranston. I think we saw him rope one to the right side earlier on in the game as well. So
yeah, I think you're right. Cranston definitely jumped all over that first pitch fastball. He's up there ready to hit. Just was a little bit out in front of it. See if he'll straighten it out here.
Yeah, that was only fouled by maybe 20 feet or so. Here's a delivery. That's going to be outside, so 1-1 the count. Cranston, Smoot, Lone Star, the batters in the inning. 2 lefties and then a righty here for De La Salle. Yeah, and he got around on that pitch pretty quickly. And that certainly wake up Mr. Kimmel. That pitch now is outside. 2-1 to Cranston.
Kimmel not happy he didn't get the outside corner on that one.
Yeah, definitely not. His location a little lacking here at the moment. 2-1. Here's a delivery, and that's going to be high for ball 3. So again, trying to paint that outside corner. 2 low pitches, and now one above the letters. Go 3-1. So don't forget, he wore Kevin Hare to start off that last inning and then got bailed out with the double play. Now that's a pitch on the outside corner, and full count now for Kimmel.
Yeah, Kimmel was bailed out by some spectacular sparkling defense last inning.
Yeah, Cameron
to lead off this inning with a walk, too.
Here he comes. 3-2 pitch is outside for ball 4. Did he get him?
Yeah.
Oh, he did. Wow, a late call by the umpire as Cranston was already halfway down to first base. He'd already flipped the bat over there to the De La Salle side, but he's out. Wow, good pitch there from Kimmel for his first strikeout of the day.
Yeah, he definitely got that outside corner call. Cranston couldn't believe it. He was halfway to first base and didn't even look up at the umpire as he jogged back to the dugout, so obviously wasn't happy about that call.
So Cranston goes down looking, and I'll bring up Smoot. He'll be followed by Lone Star. Smoot wearing number 12, left-handed batting first baseman. Crowds the inside portion of the plate, delivery, curveball, misses inside. So quickly, 2 balls and 0 strikes here to Smoot. And that was about the longest look of the day from an umpire we've seen. About 2 or 3 seconds to analyze the pitch, but gave Kimmel the outside portion of the plate for the strikeout. And now that's another pitch there back on the outside corner. For strike 1. 2 balls and 1 strike now.
And Kimmel trying to stay away. Needs that outside corner in order to be successful. Starting to get the call here.
See if he comes back inside with a fastball here. Here's a delivery. Just outside again.
Staying outside, yeah. 3-1 is the count here with 1 out. And big Alan Smoot trying to get his first hit of the afternoon.
And grounded out 3-1 in the first. And sacrifice bunt 5-3 in the fourth. Here's the delivery. Full count. That's flied off left side. Foul. Count will remain full, or go to full, excuse me, 3-2.
You got to like the way De La Salle plays the game. You know, and everybody is treated the same. They all try to, you know, they all bunt. They're all asked to bunt. Mm-hmm. They're asked to take pitches. They all play good defense, and they don't play any favorites. Well-coached team and definitely a productive team.
Full-count pitch is grounded short. Santos has it on a hop. Good play by Farley to scoop that one out of the dirt for the out. That's a tough scoop by Kevin Farley there on a tough hop. And Santos really gunned that one across the infield. Had to be there from the sophomore shortstop. And considering he just came up from JV, has had some struggles at the plate, but boy, his feeling's been impressive so far.
Yeah, definitely. Outside of one play that he thinks he should have had on that when he was playing in and allowed De La Salle's first run, he's really played some spectacular shortstop. But that play was all about Kevin Farley. That was a real tough dig out of the dirt there. That bounced probably 3-4 feet in front of him, and he just snared it with a swiping catch with his glove hand. Super play by Farley.
And now Kimmel on the first pitch strike to Lone Star sends that one wide, and the count evens at a ball and strikes. So Steve Herding would follow. Herding also looking for his first base hit of the day. Lone Star, an RBI single in the fourth inning. Here's a delivery from Kimmel, and that's low for ball two. 2-1 now to the DH for De La Salle. Right-handed bat, went 4-3 in the second. RBI single in the fourth. Lone Star, nice piece of opposite field hitting, but that drops foul. About 5 or 6 feet wide of the line. That's unlucky there for Lone Star, because plenty of space in right field. If that one had gone foul, that's a stand-up double for sure. But a good play all the same, though, by Allman, hustling over there to cover. So count 2-2 now to Austin Lone Star. Kimmel, curveball, hit by Lone Star, ranging and making a fine play in shallow center field. Is Roberts there? A backhand catch for the third out of the inning. And California, a knock going away as we go to the bottom of the sixth. It's De La Salle 3, California 2. Really? More spectacular defense by California.
Yeah, really nice play by Travis Roberts, who didn't hesitate for an instant. It looked like he took off on that ball as Lone Star was swinging. And from my view, it looked like it was going to fall for sure. But man, Roberts was able to run that sucker down and make a really fantastic over-the-shoulder catch to end the inning and keep this thing as close can be. One-run game heading into the bottom of the sixth inning.
Boy, these middle infielders for California have some range. We saw in the fifth inning with Santos going out almost to the line in shallow left field to reel in the ball. And then we see Roberts ranging like maybe a third of the way out there into center field. Well off the dirt to reel in that one from Lone Star. So
I get the feeling we're going to be seeing a lot more of this California team. Especially with the second baseman and Roberts and Santos there. They both hit 1-2. They play shortstop at second baseman, and they're both underclassmen. This California team, is this program, as a whole, is going to be sitting pretty for at least the next 2 years with these guys around.
Yeah, and don't forget, Allman's a sophomore. He's the right fielder. We got Velasquez as a sophomore, the catcher. And then we've got also Santos, the shortstop, and then a host of juniors as well. So, yeah, they should be at least in the talk for the East Bay Athletic League going into 2012-2013. But for now, all eyes are on the bottom of the sixth inning. And can they do some damage here against Andrew Buckley, who's come out once again? However, there are two pitchers warming up for De La Salle, number 8, John Keene, and number 15, A.J. Puckett. And that might be the man to watch. He's 8-2 on the year for the Spartans. In the meantime, it's Thomas Peters stepping in, the 3, 4, and 5 hitters here for California in the bottom of the sixth inning. Pitch is low. From Buckley to Thomas Peter. So Peter's struck out in both plate appearances so far, and he really wants to get something going here, the number 3 hitter for California. And that's hit down the line, and it's going to go through the third baseman. That's going to be a single. And actually, he's going to round second. He's going for second. He's going to have to dive head first. He's there, and he's safe.
Wow. Play. Unbelievable hustle getting second base on that with a head first dive just in front of the tag. What a great heads up play by Thomas Peter taking the second base on that play. hot shot down the hole. Looks like a third baseman made a great play to even get a glove on it, but wasn't unable to corral it, hustled to the ball, and Peter took second base and got the dive in just ahead of the throw.
Smack down the line by Peter, and as Todd said, Fornacci actually did a great job to just to halt the ball there. Went off to his right side, but Peter was made up his mind, I think, as soon as he went around first base, a wide turn, and Ricky Henderson would have been proud of that head first slide in the second base. So California now have a runner on second, no outs, and trailing by a run here in the bottom of the sixth.
I think you're right, Steven. I think he was thinking double all the way.
So here's Farley now standing in. First pitch of ball to the senior first baseman. And that's going to be outside as well. So two balls, no strikes now. It's Thomas Peter on the second pitch. Ropes one down the left field line for a double. And now Kevin Farley, with a runner in scoring position, has a chance to put Cal back on level terms with the Spartans. That pitch is swung on and missed. Good pitch there by Buckley. Two balls and a strike.
Yeah, if you're head coach, sure. If you're manager, excuse me, David Jeans of De La Salle, you wanted Buckley to come in and face these 3-4-5 guys, but it'll be interesting to see if he sticks with them, if Cal is able to keep going here.
Farley takes a pitch. Good
nice pitch
there from Buckley, 2-2. Yeah, you figure if Farley can get on base here, then Jeans has got to start seriously considering a move here with two runners on. And and Farley, of course, here represents the go-ahead run.
Yep.
Peter on second is the tying run right now, and he's definitely made up for his two earliest strikeouts with a crucial double. Now, delivery from Buckley is in the dirt, and that's a nice job there by Cranston to prevent that one from going past him, and that could have been trouble. That one went to the backstop. Full count now to Farley. The second one he's faced today. He did walk, of course, in the second. See if Buckley gives him something to hit here. Tries to paint the corners. Here's the pitch. It's going to be in there for strike three. Wow, Farley can't believe it. Looks back at the umpire. Wants a word. He said, I can't believe that pitch was over the outside corner of the plate. So Farley K's. Strikes out looking. Chorus of boos from the California side, but that's Buckley's seventh strikeout now of the day.
Well, Farley had a point. It did look a little bit outside, but hey, I mean, you got to be protecting with two strikes there.
He's also been giving Buckley that outside pitch all day long, yep, as well, mm-hmm. So you really can't imagine he's going to change his strike call right now, especially in a crucial point of the game.
Yeah, I think this North Coast section umpire crew has done a pretty consistent job.
Yeah, I have to agree with you there.
Tough break for Farley, though. One out.
And a chance to be the real hero there for California if he's able to score Peter from second base. In the meantime, he's back on the bench, and it's Daniel DeFazio. He's also looking for his first hit. He swings, looking for the fences there, swinging a miss. Count
big
equals at a point and strike.
DeFazio. Excuse me, Steve.
No problem. But yeah, he was swinging for the fences for sure.
He's looking to take the lead with one swing on that one.
Time called as Badar has to attend to a shoelace issue. Now back to the action. Ball and the strike here to the DH, Daniel DeFazio. Here's the delivery. Pitch is swung on a miss. And now you think, you get the feeling DeFazio is just trying a little bit too hard with the swing.
That might have been Buckley's fastest pitch of the night, and pitch number 86. That high fastball still looks pretty good here well into the sixth inning.
So counting Buckley's favor here. Ball and two strikes with one out. Runner on second base is Thomas Peter. 3-2. De La Salle lead here in the bottom of the sixth inning.
All the Cal Grizzlies are on their feet supporting DeFazio, hoping they can get that one big hit they've been needing.
Still just a one pitcher up in the bullpen. That's A.J. Puckett. Oh, swung on a miss. There's another fastball. A little extra sizzle on that one from Buckley. And he gets DeFazio swinging. So the eighth strikeout now for Buckley in the second in this inning alone. Remember, he struck out three in the first, two in the third, one in the fourth, and now two in the sixth inning. So Buckley now has a chance to silence the roar of the Grizzlies here if he can finish off the pinch hitter here. This is going to be J.D. McDonald in for Velasquez. Velasquez, though, has had a tough day, grounding out 5-3 in the second, striking out in the fourth. So McDonald, 24 games, spanned just 200.
He's done such a good job behind the plate, though. I'm surprised that Velasquez is being taken out at this point, but clearly Coach Ward thinks that this is now or never time with the tying run and scoring position to his bench.
He should be able to keep his position, though. I think pinch hitters here don't necessarily have to replace their counterpart. And that pitch is inside as Cranston tried to frame the pitch there. Ball, no strikes now to McDonald. Pinch hitting here for Velasquez.
So they're able to still maintain Velasquez at behind the plate.
Pretty sure.
Oh, good.
And that pitch is over the plate. Good pitch there by Buckley. And he's responded well here after the leadoff double from Peter. Peter's still frozen in position on second. One ball, one strike, two outs here. Pinch hitter McDonald at the plate for California. Delivery is outside, 2-1. Tyler Johnson would follow. So 2-1 the count now to McDonald. Right-handed bat. Open stance. Look back to second from Buckley, but no one covering second for De La Salle. And you think Puckett is ready to come in should something go wrong here for De La Salle. Runner on second base is Peter. Pitch is high, 3-1 to McDonald. This could be a shrewd move here by Coach Ward if McDonald's able to get on base. At this point, of course, of the season, it doesn't really matter how you do it. Some patient play here by McDonald and forcing Buckley to throw to him. There's the pitch over the corner of the plate. Strike two, so full count now for McDonald.
Big pitch upcoming here. Full count, two outs here in the bottom of the sixth.
Buckley from the first base side sets, delivers, pitches high for ball four, going down to third uncontested is Peter. So McDonald on a full count walks, and California have runners on the corners now with McDonald on first and Peter on third as he took off uncontested. And that might be it for Buckley. I think it is. I think they're going to call for Puckett here as Jeans comes out to the mound. Conference on the mound here for De La Salle. Two runners on for California here in the bottom of the sixth with two outs. And perhaps they're not going to go to the bullpen just yet. Let's wait and see here. Jeans calls the entire infield in. Coach Ward, on the meantime, has gone over for a quick word with his batters here. It will be Johnson to bat for California. Thomas Peter comes over from third base for a quick instruction. And the umpire here ready to go out to the mound to break up the conference. So, an entertaining end to our 2012 broadcast season here on CIFNorthCoast.tv in this Division I baseball final between California and De La Salle. It's De La Salle 3, California 2 here in the bottom of the sixth inning. But California knocking on the door. And a chance here for Tyler Johnson to play hero with a tying run on third, the go-ahead run on first, and two outs now in the inning. As Buckley, on his 92nd pitch, or 93rd pitch, walks the pinch hitter McDonald. Here's a pitch over the outside corner of the plate for a strike. It is indeed Tyler Johnson, the left-handed hitter at the plate. Singled and got an RBI in the second, grounded out 6-3 in the fourth. Johnson, left-handed bat, a big chance here. Off goes McDonald the second. He's going to get down there uncontested as they throw back to Buckley. McDonald's got a good lead, and he'll steal second base. So it's McDonald on second now and Peter on third. And if Johnson can just find a gap here, you think at least one runner could score, and potentially two. Let's see what happens. Here's the delivery. Buckley delivers. It's swung on by Johnson, off into foul ground, a little confusion there, and De La Salle come up with it. As Fornacci comes across to reel that one in, as the catcher came out as well, and De La Salle get out of the inning as Johnson pops out to the third baseman. So we go to the top of the seventh inning. It's De La Salle 3, California 2.
Tough opportunity lost there by California, having the tying and go-ahead runs in scoring position, and Tyler Johnson, who had a nice hit in the second inning, comes up and just gets one off the hands into foul territory. So De La Salle, a real gutsy effort from Andrew Buckley today, I have to say, Steve, in order to pitch six innings against this very game California lineup and able to keep them basically down. Five hits and two runs scored. While De La Salle's offense has basically struggled throughout, only getting two hits in total, one of them being the first hit of the game. So
right.
It's been, you know, basically six innings of one hit ball by Ball and
Kimmel.
And Kimmel. So I guess De La Salle lucky to be a lead, but they still be ahead. But they certainly earned it by doing all the little things and pitching, doing some clutch defense and some clutch pitching when they definitely need it. So we got three more outs to go. Let's see if De La Salle can add an insurance run here in the seventh in this 3-2 ball game.
Yeah, they haven't had a hit since Lone Star singled and scored the RBI in the fourth inning. So we'll be hurting Fornacci and Bedard coming up for De La Salle here in the top of the seventh inning. For California, it'll be Guardino, Allman, and Santos in the bottom of the seventh for California. So here's a delivery from Kimmel's high for ball one to Herding.
Kimmel's done a nice job so far. We're now pitching in his third inning. Had some nice defensive help, but he's done very well coming up in relief.
Yeah, just 20 pitches thrown. That's grounded to short on two hops, firing. Santos just got there in time. Wow. High throw from Santos. Farley had to climb the ladder to reel it in and was just able to get the foot down in time before Herding reached the bag.
Really making Farley work over there for everything at first base, but he's been up for the challenge with his third sparkling defensive play over there on throws from first.
Kevin Farley, 6'1", 190. He had to be about 6'7" there to reel that in from Santos. But again, play over at short has been at times spectacular tonight. Did well to field that one on two hops. So one out quickly now. As Herding goes down 6-3, and I'll bring up Fornacci, and that's a strike to the third baseman. So Bedard will follow. Twilight hours now at the Coliseum. Floodlights in full effect. And the wind has subsided at the moment. There's a pitch swung on, fouled off right side. So quickly, Fornacci down two strikes here in the top of the seventh. Get the feeling we're building towards a fascinating finale here in this Division I final. De La Salle holding on to a one-run lead, but again, just on two hits. A triple by Mercado and a single by Lone Star back in the fourth. But three runs for the Spartans. Here's an inside pitch fouled off. Fornacci does well to stay in this at bat. 0-2 the count.
Been some well-played baseball throughout this entire North Coast Championship day here at the Oakland Coliseum.
Absolutely, and we think back to the game we did earlier on today. Somehow you can win with 11 walks.
Incredible.
Yeah, and one hit.
Yeah, we might see a team win giving up 11 walks and another team win only getting two hits if things hold the form as is.
And that's strike three. Wow, Fornacci looking. Second K of the day for the third baseman. So he punched out in the second, swinging, and now looking in the seventh. And I'll bring up Bedard. And this is the time now for Adam Kimmel, where he's really got to just come up with the best pitches of the season here and get the Grizzly offense back out on the field as quickly as possible. Here's the first delivery. It's inside. I almost hit him. So ball one to Bedard. Looking over my score sheet here, just five walks issued by both sets of pitches today. And that pitch is grounded foul down the left field line. So the count evens at a ball and a strike. To think they got half the walk total of Tamil Pius. Back in the Division III game earlier on. That's grounded back to the pitcher. Wow, nice job there by Kimmel to snag that one on a hop. So Bedard grounds out to the pitcher. And we have three outs. It's California's game now. Trailing by a run. They need to get at least one to send this to extra innings. And after 6.5, it's De La Salle 3, California 2.
That's a hot shot there by Bedard. Nice play by Kimmel to field that cleanly and get it over to first. And it's do-or-die time for the Grizzlies. Their crowd getting into it, trying to support them and inspire them. They got a chance to tie this game or to win it right here in the bottom of the seventh with Guardino, Allman, and Santos scheduled to hit. We'll see what Dan Ward wants to do.
Well, be interesting to see at the very – well, Guardino, you think, would be in there for sure because he had the triple back in the second inning.
Is Buckley back out there for De La Salle to close this thing out? Looks
yes,
like number
is.
Two to me.
Wow, so here's Buckley on 95 pitches, 36 balls to 59 strikes. And, yeah, Coach Jeans has opted to go with his starter here to try and close this out for De La Salle. He does have Puckett and Keene at the ready in the bullpen. They've been warming up for what seems like an eternity now. Well, they're definitely both warm if he opts to go to the bullpen here. But he's going to, in the meantime, stay with Buckley. And, well, watching him do his final warm-up pitches there, and that was well wide of the target. So let's see how Buckley can deal with the nerves and also the fatigue as well. But as we've seen so far, no real loss in the velocity of the fastball. And he's going to need it all here in the bottom of the seventh. He faces the 8, 9, and 1 hitters, Guardino, Allman, and Santos. And the first man to the plate will be number 6, Blake Guardino. Does California have one more run left in them? This miracle run to the playoffs. They defeated Bishop O'Dowd, Deer Valley, and Monta Vista on the way to this title game. After losing both to the two Pleasanton teams, Amador Valley and Foothill, they had to beat Monta Vista to get into this playoff battle, and they defeated them 3-2 on the final game of the season. Here's the first pitch. That's low from Buckley.
And then they won all three of their playoff games on the road
yeah.
in order to get into this game. I mean, they have a shot. I guess when you woke up this morning, would you say last licks down one against De La Salle? I think they might take that bet, so we'll see what happens.
Well, an unnamed co-commentator of ours didn't really fancy the chances of a certain California team, but right now they're still very much in this game. It's a two-ball, no-strike count, and that one's over the plate for a strike to Guardino.
The unnamed Michael Smith.
Yeah, well, there you go. He just blew it. Apologies to you, Michael, if you're listening, by the way. 2-1 the count here to the Grizzlies. That one's outside for ball three, so Buckley a little trouble with the location. And as you can imagine, all eyes on from the De La Salle bullpen over here to the mound.
Guardino looking fastball here, 3-1.
Yep. Here's a delivery. He gets the fastball. That's low in the dirt. So Guardino has tripled. Grounded out 3-1. And now has walked as well. That's the 100th pitch of the night from Buckley. So the first runner on now. The tying run is on first for California. And here comes Nick Allman. He singled in the fifth. Flied out to center in the second. So this bottom of the bottom of the order here for California in particular has really done their job here tonight. And now there'll be a conference on the mound. Guardino will come over for a quick word with Coach Ward. Meanwhile, Cranston will go out for a word with Buckley and figure out some strategy here to pitch to the left-hander.
It's been a good team effort from Cal, 1-9. Good defense and timely hitting. Can they get one more magical inning?
Buckley said success finding the outside portion of the plate to right-handed batters. Can he do the same to the left-handed batters as well, especially in the most crucial time of the season here for De La Salle? They lead 3-2 here in the seventh. California have a runner on as Guardino was walked on 5 pitches. So Buckley sets and delivers. Oh, and Allman showed bunt momentarily and then swung for the fences. He misses. No balls and a strike now.
Sophomore Allman looks pretty comfortable in there in this situation.
Certainly does. All four sophomores have played a role in this game for California. McDonald with a crucial walk in the last inning. And of course, Velasquez, Allman, and
Santos.
Yeah. All playing roles in the game as well. So that's a ball and a strike. So that pitch is outside. Try and see who's going to follow here. If they'll stick with Santos. And they have. It looks like they are going to go with a pinch hitter here for California. We'll get to that in just a minute. Now in the meantime, it's 1-1 the count here. No outs, runner on first. California show bunt. They drop one down. Back to the pitcher's mound. It'll be a sacrifice bunt as Guardino gets down to second base. It's a sacrifice bunt back to the pitcher there for Allman.
Some confusion there at first base. Smoot and Hare didn't know who was going to cover first base. It looked like the second baseman Hare came over and took the throw from Buckley for the first out. But The sophomore Allman does his job and moves the runner over to scoring position. That's your tying runner sitting out there on second base, Blake Gardino, with the top of the lineup coming up.
Here's Shayla Ghiberti, the pinch hitter here for California. He's a left-hand bat, so they're wondering if they can get the same success they got from McDonald. He swings at the first pitch. Boy, he was swinging for the fences there, and Buckley blazes a fastball by. So it's Ghiberti batting for Santos here with one out. Runner on second base is Guardino. And really, you just got to get the guy down to third base here. And that pitch is inside, almost hit him. Wow. And a good job there by Cranston to prevent that one from going to the backstop. So count 1-0. It's Ghiberti, the junior. Pitcher in outfield, 5'10", 155, left-handed bat. We're in number 16 here for California. Runner on second. And he swings again and misses. 1-2 the count now to Ghiberti.
A couple of good swings from Ghiberti, just a little bit behind it.
Travis Roberts on deck. One out now. One ball, should be two strikes here because Ghiberti fanned at the first pitch. Here it comes. That's inside. That almost hit him again.
Yeah, 2-2 is the count here to Ghiberti.
Buckley's 107th pitch of the night coming up right here. Runner on second base is Blake Guardino. He walked to start off the inning, then was sacrificed down to second by Allman. 2-2. The count. Delivery. Is inside, ball three, going down to third base and in time. Oh, and he thought about going home there for a moment as the ball caromed off the third base.
I thought he might take off as well, but the ball, wise decision to stay there because the ball was kicked up into the air by the third baseman, Fornacci, and he was able to sort of keep it within his vicinity, but still moving up 90 feet is Guardino, who's only one hit to the right side away from tying this ball game up.
Yeah, now Ghiberti, all he has to do is just put the ball in play. Just hit it out to the outfield, and they'll score from third. Here's a delivery. Swung on and missed. He punches out. Ghiberti goes down swinging for the second out now.
And it's all up to Travis Roberts here.
It is indeed. That's Buckley's ninth strikeout. And this is an impressive performance here by the junior. Young Buck. 109 pitches on the night. 9 Ks. Crowd on their feet now for this, what could be the final out of the game. De La Salle 3, California 2. Runner on third is Blake Guardino. And a chance for Roberts to play hero once again. Here it comes. Pitch is swung on, foul off right side. No balls and a strike.
Looks like Roberts, if he's going to go down, he's going to go down swinging. He took a gigantic hack at that first offering from Buckley. He's ready to hit.
Buckley from the third base side. Sets. And delivers. Here it comes. Pitch is outside. Ball one. 1-1 the count. Do or die time here for California. Base hit would tie the game for sure. 1-1. Here's the delivery. Pitch is outside. 2-1 the count.
112 pitches for Buckley. He's getting a little bit wild on that fastball. Needs to bear down for a couple more pitches here.
They don't want Roberts to get on because Peter doubled, of course, in the sixth after striking out in his first two plate appearances. And now Roberts will call for time.
Looks like he's going to move back into the windup here.
This will be Buckley's... Wait and see if the scoreboard will change back here. 113th pitch of the night coming up. Here's the delivery. That was gunned to right field. It's playable here. Chance for Mercado to reel it in, which he does. De La Salle have won their first Division I championship here in 2012 and erasing the bitter defeat they suffered against James Logan last year. As Roberts flies out to right field, it's reeled in by Hunter Mercado and De La Salle, the 2012 Division I champions with a hard-fought 3-2 victory over the California Grizzlies.
Wow, what a great game. California definitely played their hearts out of this terrific playoff run to make it to this championship game. They gave De La Salle all they could handle and then some, but in the end it was De La Salle able to pull it off with just a spectacular performance from Mr. Buckley going the distance for the 3-2 victory.
Yeah, what a performance there by Andrew Buckley. 113 pitches thrown, on the night. Let's see if we can toll up his line here real quick. Well, actually, we'll take a short break, and we'll be right back to give you our CIFNorthCoast.tv player of the game. And we'll do that in just a moment here on CIFNorthCoast.tv. Back with you live on CIFNorthCoast.tv. What a game to conclude our 2012 broadcast schedule here on CIFNorthCoast.tv as De La Salle pulled out a 3-2 victory over a gutsy California team. And, well, it wasn't a difficult decision here for our player of the game, and that has to go to the De La Salle starting pitcher, Andrew Buckley.
Yeah, definitely. Andrew Buckley going the distance, 10 Ks, 3 walks, only gave up 5 hits and the 2 runs. Every time he had a tough situation, he came through, and he deserves this Player of the Game award, absolutely.
Yeah, he certainly did. And plenty of times there were California really threatened, in particular when they got 2 runners on in the 6th inning, and they were able to shut him down, striking out Farley and DeFazio, and then getting Johnson to pop out to end that 6th inning, the real final chance that California had to get back on level terms here with the Spartans. But again, an excellent line, 113 pitches thrown, 27 batters faced, struck out 10 of them, walking 3, giving up 5 hits and 2 runs. Quite the performance from the junior. And, of course, for all those teams out there in East Bay Athletic League, he will be back for senior year next year.
Yeah, and a special congratulations to the California Grizzlies for just an inspired effort throughout these playoffs, and they just fell short in the last inning. They couldn't get that run across from third, but this is a team that you're going to be hearing a lot from in the future with so many good young players. So congratulations to the California Grizzlies. They have nothing to be ashamed of, but De La Salle is your Division I champion here in the North Coast section.
Yeah, Adam Kimmel had 3 solid innings in particular in relief, really limiting De La Salle to just 2 hits on the day. And looking at Kimmel's line since he came in, got a couple of strikeouts and then got everyone else out on groundouts. So really, really nice job by the junior relief pitcher there, Adam Kimmel, to come in and mop up for Cody Ball, who had an excellent game himself. He threw 81 pitches over 4 innings, striking out 5, walking 1, giving up the 3 runs, though, on the 2 hits. So 3 innings of scoreless, hitless relief by Adam Kimmel for California. But unfortunately, not enough for the Grizzlies, as De La Salle take their 7th North Coast Section Baseball crown, their first in Division 1, and, of course, making up for the 1-0 loss to the Colts of James Logan in 2011 at James Logan High School. That game was rained out on the 4th of June, and the makeup game played on the 6th of June of last year. The floodlights are out here at the Oakland Coliseum, and unfortunately for our broadcast listeners out there, the season concludes here in 2012 on CIFNorthCoast.tv. A fitting end to the season with a fantastic game here played by De La Salle and California. But fret not, high school sports fans out there, we will be back in due course. We'll be back in late August for the beginning of the 2012-2013 academic year, and of course, football season will soon be upon us. Don't forget to check out all of our coverage, as we will be covering Foothill and Valley Christian, and perhaps some teams to be determined as well here in the North Coast section. But exciting times lie ahead for all of us here related to high school sports, and especially all of us here at Play On Sports. We thank you for listening, and and enjoying our broadcast here in 2011, 2012. For our entire team, let's name them real quick. Alex Richmond, Todd Flournoy, Harold Mills, Michael Stanisic, Craig Ludwig, James Davies, Michael Smith, and me, Stephen Davies. We thank you all for listening. We'll see you in September. We look forward to it. Goodbye for now.